Hi students, today we are going to learn the how to bleach the cotton material by using calcium hypochlorite or bleaching powder. Calcium hypochlorite we also called as bleaching powder or chlorinated lime. It is prepared by reaction of calcium hydroxide and chlorine gas. Cotton can be bleached with hypochlorite solution at room temperature containing 1-3 GPL available chlorine per liter at pH range of 9.5 to 11. As we know that calcium hypochlorite is a strong oxidizing bleaching agent and also it capable of giving oxygen at room temperature. So we can bleach the cotton material at room temperature. For obtaining effective bleaching results, we need to maintain 1-3 GPL available chlorine concentration in bleaching bath. The pH is maintained by using 5 GPL sodium carbonate in bleaching bath and it also enhances the bleaching action during bleaching process. After completion of bleaching, the bleaching material is treated with 1 to 1.5% HCl for removing any residual traces of alkali present in the bleached material and it needs to be neutralized. Otherwise, the alkali may get concentrated and result in the formation of oxycellulose during drying and also it imparts ash feel to the cloth. So, the process of removing and neutralizing any traces of alkali present in the bleached material is called souring process. And also, we need to remove the any residual chlorine atoms present in the bleached material, so which causes formation of chloromines and it consequences to after yellowing of the material on storage. For preventing this fault, an anti-chlorine treatment is given to the bleached material with dilute solution of sodium bisulfate or sodium thiosulfate or sodium hydrosulfate with concentration of 1 GPL at 60 degree centigrade for 5 to 10 minutes. What are the advantages and disadvantages of hypochlorite bleaching process is, first the advantages are low chemical cost. So we know that the cost of bleaching powder is very cheap in market. Next, low energy input. So we are carrying the bleaching process at room temperature, so we no need any extra energy for this process. And low cost of equipment. Next, the disadvantages of this process is rapid bleaching is not possible with hypochlorite and there is a danger of yellowing of bleached fiber on storage and there is a danger of tendering of the material if pH and temperature are not controlled and the formation of high level of AOX means absorbable organic halogens. It results in environmental hazards. Principle of calcium hypochlorite bleaching. Calcium hypochlorite is a oxidizing agent which is a calcium salt of hypochlorous acid. Hypochlorous acid liberates hypochlorite ion, the species of which bleaches the material. So the calcium hypochlorite on its dissociation it liberates hypochlorous acid and hypochlorite ion. So the hypochlorite ion liberates nascent oxygen. So the nascent oxygen decomposes the natural coloring matter completely into simpler compound. Next, the recipe for calcium hypochlorite bleaching is MLR 1:30, calcium hypochlorite 5 to 15 GPL and we need to maintain 3 GPL available chlorine and sodium carbonate is 3 to 5 gram per liter and wetting agent 1 to 2 GPL and pH we need to maintain 10 to 11. The temperature we need to maintain room temperature and the time for this process is 60 to 90 minutes. Next, here we first weigh the scoured material. So we are here taken 5 gram cover material for bleaching purpose and note down the reading. Conditions of bleaching process is weight of material being taken 5 grams and the material to liquor ratio is 1:30. So the volume of liquor is 5 × 30 is equal to 150 ml, and calcium hypochlorite for 15 GPL. So the 15 GPL of calcium hypochlorite means 15 grams of calcium hypochlorite required for each liter in total volume of liquor for bleaching process. Therefore, volume of calcium hypochlorite for 150 ml of liquor is equal to volume of liquor into gram per liter of calcium hypochlorite divided by 1000. So the result is 2.25 grams. So we need to take 2.25 grams for 150 ml of liquor. So we made a lab stock solution of 10% of calcium hypochlorite. So we need to take 22.5 ml in 10% of stock solution for bleaching process. Next, Na2CO3 5 GPL. So the 5 GPL means 5 grams of NO2CO3 required for each liter in total volume of liquor for bleaching process. Therefore, volume of NO2CO3 for 150 ml of liquor is equal to volume of liquor into GPL of NO2CO3 divided by 1000. Hence, the answer is 0.75 grams. So the lab stock solution of Na2CO3 we made 10%. So we need to prepare it in 7.5 ml in 10% stock solution. Wetting agent 2 GPL. So as previously done, like Na2CO3 and calcium hypochlorite, this also same process. Like 2 GPL means 2 gram of wetting agent required for each liter in bleaching process. So therefore, 150 into 2 divided by 1000 is equal to 0.3 grams. So we made a lab stock solutions for 10% stock solution. 0.3 into 100 divided by 10 is equal to 3 ml. So we need to pipette 3 ml of wetting agent in 10% stock solution. Next, need to find the total volume of water to be taken for bleaching process. Hence, the formula is volume of liquor minus volume of calcium hypochlorite plus volume of Na2CO3 plus volume of wetting agent. So 150 minus 22.5 plus 7.5 ml plus 3 ml is equal to 117 ml. So we need to take 170 ml of water and need to pipette after by stock solutions Na2CO3 7.5 ml and calcium hypochlorite 22.5 ml and wetting agent 3 ml by stock solutions. Preparation of calcium hypochlorite 10% stock solution. We are here taken 10 grams of concentration bleaching powder and taken 100 ml of water and added to the into the glass beaker. Then the bleaching powder is added into the 100 ml of glass beaker. Then the bleaching powder mixed thoroughly and properly, so it is soluble in water easily. Then need to filter the calcium hypochlorite solution with using filter paper, so we get a clear solution of calcium hypochlorite. For achieving even and effective bleaching of cotton, here adding calcium hypochlorite solution into the reagent bottle through filter paper. So add little amount of calcium hypochlorite solution for better filtration. See, we are make a clear solution of 10% stock solution for bleaching process. Next, preparation of bleaching bath. So here taken 117 ml of water as per calculation we made in bleaching calculations. First we taken 100 ml by measuring cylinder and added into the glass beaker. Then we taken 17 ml, so totally we have added 117 ml of water to the bleaching bath. Next we pipetting 22.5 ml of calcium hypochlorite in 10% stock solution and added into the bleaching bath. First we have taken 10 ml again, we are going to pipette 10 ml and added into the bleaching bath. Then we are pipette 2.5 ml. So totally we add 22.5 ml of calcium hypochlorite by 10% stock solution of see 2.5 ml we are added into the beaker. So totally we have pipetting 22.5 ml of calcium hypochlorite solution. Next we are pipetting 7.5 ml of sodium carbonate in a 10% of stock solution. Here we had 7.5 ml as per calculation we made in bleaching calculations. So we are adding sodium carbonate 7.5 ml, so it enhances the bleaching action and also it maintains the pH of bleaching bath. Next we are going to pipette 3 ml of wetting agent of by 10% stock solution of wetting agent. So it increases the wettability of the fiber and also it enhances the penetration of bleach liquor into the inner molecular structure of the cotton fiber. So we have totally made a 150 ml of volume of liquor. For checking of available chlorine in bleaching bath, please go through the link I have put in a description box. The bleaching bath is ready now. Then we are taken pre-prepared and wetted material is taken and squeezed properly. Then added into the bleaching bath. The bleaching process is carried and stirred occasionally for achieving even bleaching. So the bleaching process carried out about 1 to 1.5 hours. So after completion of bleaching process, we need to give after treatment to the bleached cotton material. First, we have taken the bleached cotton material from bleaching bath and give a cold wash. Firstly, using cold water for 5 to 10 minutes. So after completion of cold wash, the bleached material is transferred into hot bath, that is we are maintaining 70 degree for 5 to 10 minutes. We are giving hot wash for bleached cotton material. After cold wash, we have giving hot wash at 70 degree centigrade for 5 to 10 minutes. After completion of hot wash, the bleached cotton material is treated with 1.5% HCl for giving souring treatment. Preparation of 1.5% HCl for souring. Here we take 98.5 ml of water in a glass beaker and take 1.5 ml of concentration HCl and add it into the glass beaker. So it makes 1.5% of concentration of HCl. See, we are preparing 1.5 ml into the 98.5 ml of water. So it makes 1.5% HCl dilution. So we transfer into the steel pot. So it is a 1.5% of HCl. Then we transferred the bleached material from hot wash to souring bath. So here we giving a souring treatment to the bleached material for removing or neutralizing the any alkali present in the bleached material. Next, the anti-chlorine treatment is given to the bleached cotton material for removing any chlorine atoms present in the bleached cotton material. So here we have taken 0.5 gram of sodium thiosulfate and added into the 500 ml of water we have taken in a steel pot. So mix with the glass rod and it makes a 1 gpl of sodium thiosulfate solution, and the bleaching material transferred into the from souring bath to anti-chlorine treatment bath. Treatment is giving at 60 degree centigrade for 5 to 10 minutes. After completion of anti-chlorine treatment, the bath is taken from the digital water bath machine and given once again hot wash and cold wash. Then sample is squeezed properly and the bleached material is dry in a hot air oven. So here we are observing the scoured material is bleached successfully by using calcium hypochlorite or bleaching powder. Thanks for watching this video. Please do subscribe for uploading more videos. Thank you and bye.